Hey guys, welcome back. This video, another DIY video, I'm gonna build a modular storage unit for my workbench here, for my craft tools and brushes and sanders and stuff for under $30. So let's go ahead and get started. So guys, welcome back. So a lot of people love my video where I did the IKEA hack with the Alex drawing unit where I turned to my paint rack. So this time I thought I was going to do something a little bit different, and I'm going to do a modular storage unit for all my, nice and neat, for all my paints and tools and brushes and sanders, all that kind of craft stuff. I want to put in one neat modular organizer. Now, there's a few products out there. There's Hobby Zone, do some wood kind of MDF, like laser cut ones, which are pretty big. I've had them in the past, and actually have one behind my shoulder if my neat oils. So-so, I think they're okay. I don't really like the wood side of it. I like something more plasticky, which we'll talk about in a minute. And very deep as well, so take a lot of space up on the bench. Now, UMP Ultimate Modeling Products do a really nice modular 3D printed set with all the gubbins and stuff, all different types, which looks fantastic. But I'm in the US, so for me getting from the UK to the US, it's about £19.99, which is almost $30 in shipping. So it makes it a little bit cost prohibitive. So for me to get full setup of what I want is about $115. That's a little bit more than I want to expend. So it looks fantastic, perfectly designed. And if I was in the UK, I'd definitely buy it. So I thought, you know what, let's do a DIY solution and see how we go. So I searched around online and found a lot of stuff. I don't know, I found a lot of like kitchen stuff. I couldn't quite find what I was looking for. Went to the container store, all these kind of places. But I randomly came across this website called Lee Valley. I'll put a link below. And they have this storage unit. Well, it's basically designed for like the case. We have all little bit containers inside it. Store your like nuts and bolts and your screws and your hardware stuff. And they're pretty cheap. So they come in four sizes. You can see over here, you get the red ones. So they're all 6 centimeters high. And this one's 5 by 5 centimeters. And this is 80 cents. Size up is two of those, so you got a yellow one, and that's going to be 10 by 5, again 6 high, so again size of 2 reds. Then you got the square, which is a blue. Now the blue is $1.80, and this is 10 by 10, so it's, you know, it's all the same kind of sizing, got fives, right? And then finally I got a green, which is the biggest, so 4 sizes, and the green is 250 each, and that is 16 actually, so 15.9 centimeters by just over 10 centimeters. So that's like 3 of these. And that's the 4 things. So what I figured what I was gonna do here is, well, firstly, let me kind of show you quickly what I've got going on here on my bench. So you can see I got a smorgasbord of products here. I've got a pretty cool Star Wars mug holding my sanders. I got a couple of these, I think the Hobby Design, I think they're called, or Model Design, acrylic tool sets. One for my daughter's in the white, mine's in the black. And they went out of business a couple of years ago, so you can't buy their stuff anymore. And then I've got my, that works really good, my paintbrush stand is simply some plumbing fittings from Home Depot, which I spray painted silver and glued it on a piece of 3 sample of wood flooring from Home Depot. And that's really worked out really good. But I kind of want some, people with OCD, I want something all nice and like unique, like straight lines and all kind of blend into one, which goes across the back of my bench there. So found this, as I mentioned, found this solution. It's actually called the Allit, A-L-L-I-T. I think it's a German thing. It's sold by Lee Valley here in the US, and I'm sure it's sold worldwide. But again, like you're talking about $1 per container, so it's very cheap. So I got a bunch of this stuff. So I got all these reds, I've got yellows, I got blues, and I'm gonna make some kind of design here where I'm gonna stick them all together and create my kind of solution, like a nice, neat, long line. Now, I know what you're thinking. It's gonna look very elementary school, right, with these colors. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it all together and I'm gonna paint it. Now, painting plastic like this, this polyethylene or whatever it is really tough because it just peels off. It's just really hard to find a good paint. So went to my Lowe's store and found this Fusion all-in-one paint and primer, 5 times stronger adhesion. And this is matte black, but this is no peel guarantee. So I did do one, paint one, which I can't really see. Where is it? Oh, here it is, right back here. So I painted one last night, just a real quick coat, just to see. And it does look pretty good. It's not peeling or anything. It does seem pretty strong. So Home Depot does like Rust-Oleum products. Lowe's does Krylon. So Krylon Fusion, and they do, must have 50 or 100 colors, pretty much any color you can think of. Grays, pinks, blues, any color. I don't want mine to blend in and just be kind of neat. So again, I'm going for matte black. They have hammer black, satin black, gloss black, you name it, they got it. But I'm going for straightforward matte black. And like I say, I painted one right here just to see, make sure it didn't all peel and stuff. It did seem kind of dear, but it was kind of tricky to kind of paint the inside. I must admit, it was a little tricky to get in there. So that's what we've got going on. So what I'm going to simply do is I'm creating a design where I kind of like this, kind of split them all out. So I've got area for my paint brushes, my sanders. I'm going to create a design, basically glue all these guys together using some clear Gorilla Glue. Use any kind of super glue. I have this lying around, so I thought, why not? I'll use this. So I'm going to glue all these stuff, all these together, and then in one go, paint the whole thing in this. And we'll see what we got left over, see if it actually works out or not. I might end up buying a proper one at the end, but might bodge it up, but let's see how we do. So that's my quick intro, well, kind of lengthy intro, what I got going on. So let me go ahead and start working on this, and let's see how we get on. All right, so putting these together, done a few already, and it's going together pretty well. It's, if you're into model making like I am, it's actually the same plastic as model kits pretty much, so Tamiya glue kind of glues it. So let me kind of talk through what I'm doing here. So I've done these few, they're drying right now. So I'm going to do two more. So what I have found is, see, they're slightly, they're not quite square. So a slight gap at the bottom, which is 1/2 mil. So what I've taken is, I think some evergreen styrene sheet. I happen to have a mil and a 1/2 mil. I glued it together, but you can buy 1.5 mil. So that's what you need, the gap. And I just created these little kind of shims, which are literally 1/2 mil wide and 5 centimeters long. And what I'm going to do is, using some Tamiya glue, just going to glue the shim at the bottom, like so. And then when we glue these two together, it'll make it straight, so it's not going to bow. Then all I'm going to do is just take my Gorilla Glue. Again, you could use any kind of super glue. And run some top along the shim. Let you push it together and make sure it's straight, level. And that is a peg on each side and let it dry for a couple of hours, and that's it. And then these are all going to be built up together in one long line. I might do it two separate sections so I can move it around a little bit, but that gives you an idea. And again, just want to like get these, make sure they're flush, push it against the desk, make sure they're all square. And that little shim, just make sure, you know, it's not pushed bow together. And there we go, that's it, as simple as that. So I'm just going to put all these together. I've sided with these little ones with the paint brushes. I've actually glued them inside each other, double height, so it's going to be 12 centimeters. And I'm going to drill some holes in the bottom, and then you can put your paint brushes in, so it's going to make it a little bit more secure. So that's what I'm going to do with these guys, double them up. But these ones, just let dry. Again, this actually glues with Tamiya glue, okay, to cement, and it's extra thin. Because it's plastic, obviously. So just go work my way through, figure out my design, and that's how they're going together. All right, so there you go. We've got them all glued together. No problem at all with the glue. Now, I did notice the dry time on this is 2 hours to keep it clamped and about 24 hours for it to be cured. So, and it did mention that it wasn't suitable for this type of plastic, and that's the clear Gorilla Glue. So use it at your own discretion, but it seemed to work fine for me. I mean, any kind of super glue or plastic glue should work, but it seems pretty strong. Again, it's not gonna be moved around much. It's just gonna be sat on the desk and just want to hold it together. It's not gonna be like a bunch of stress on it or anything. So you can see all different colors and stuff. It's gonna look nicer when it's painted. So I'm gonna grab myself again the Krylon, the 5x stronger adhesion, no peel guarantee, special design for this kind of stuff. And it says no runs or no errors and no drips, so we'll see. When I sprayed this, it looked a little bit runny to me, but I just gotta be careful as always, just do a light coat and take your time building it up. So I had to just re-glue something on this one, so I'm gonna paint the front section tonight, start painting it. It's obviously trying to get all these gaps and areas and stuff's gonna be tricky, and then we'll do that one tomorrow. All right, so we're all painted up. Yesterday evening I painted these, and it took quite a long time. You know, the areas to get inside and around the edges and that kind of stuff. And like all good YouTube car builders, nice heavy coats with spray paint. No, I'm just kidding.
Now, it does say no runs. I do have a couple of runs, so that's not entirely accurate on the box. But, it, I mean, it does seem to adhere pretty good. But it did take a few coats. Again, slight coats and I'll flood the thing. Pro tip 3 or 4, to be honest with you, to get the kind of coverage I want over those bright kind of plastic colours. So, this spray paint does say you have 2 hours. Basically, if you want to recoat, do second coats, third coats, you've got 2 hours to work with it. After 2 hours, you've got to leave it 48 hours to cure before you can do anything else with it. So, did it last night, so it's obviously been about 12 hours, so it's still a little tacky in the inside where it's kind of went on pretty thick. So I'm literally going to leave this now for 48 hours, put the instructions, I'll be really good and patient, and then we can come back and we can kind of see how it all looks. So yeah, he noticed how I did do it in two parts. I think it'd make it easy, one rather than one giant, like long 60 centimeter strip of organizer, I think it'd be much easier to handle like this, and you can move it around or maybe reconfigure it somewhat. So yeah, let's leave it another 2 days, then we'll come back and we kind of see how it works out. All right, so we're done. It's been a few days later. Let 2 days for the paint to dry fully, and I throw everything in there. And as you can see, looking pretty good. I'm definitely glad I did the matte black because it kind of blends with my worktop here, which is IKEA desktop, by the way. I'm using IKEA stuff, which works really good, very reasonably priced, but still not enough space. So you see my, over here, my tape, nowhere for my tape yet, and tons of paint brushes didn't fit in. I've kept them in the usual thing just because I just have so much, like spare brushes and specialist brushes. The stuff I'm using right now is really in the middle here, and these are all my extras and specialists over there. But overall, it's definitely an improvement. So before, remember, I have this acrylic thing, which worked pretty good, but the cost of this is probably more expensive than all of this put together. And again, just a cheap solution. Now, I think I definitely need more. No matter what you create, you always need way more. When it comes to creating paint racks or anything like that, you always need double or triple what you think you need. And that's the case with this. But 6 centimeters high, they work okay for most part. My large sanders and stuff over there, you know, they're leaning back, but they're not falling out by any means. Same with the paint brushes. If you remember, the paint brushes back there, second row, I cut the bottom off and glued it in, so it's too high. So it's probably really about 10 centimeters high, probably, once you push it in. Stuck my sticker on there, and we're good to go. So overall, it's been a cool little project. Definitely gives you some ideas, hopefully. You know, it's modular. You can buy, again, 4 different sizes you can buy, and about range from 80 cents to, a couple of bucks each, and you just go and glue them together, whatever kind of configuration you want, and you should be good to go. But definitely narrower and giving more room on the bench here, and I think I'll give it a shot and see how it goes. If not, I can always go back to my old stuff, right? But just a short little video. Hopefully you guys find this helpful, give you some ideas. And if so, if you haven't already done so, please consider subscribing, all that kind of stuff. And I'll see you next time. Have a great one. Goodbye.